So this is the final vehicle of all the vehicles that we're using in this playoff. And well, it's none other than that legendary vehicle of all time. He's appeared in, I think, what, three or four Twisted Metal games. So that should give you a clue, and he's also a hidden vehicle for the most part in every game he's been in.
But of course, just like we've been doing in the past, we're going to go into the options and show you that it is indeed on hard. There you have it. And just like my brother said, we're going to continue our single player. This is the grand finale, of course, the final vehicle.
Pretty much the final page of the final chapter of this particular series you're watching.
Yep, and thar the vehicle blows.
Minion. And we have no information on this guy whatsoever. This Sabi's like a post-traumatic stress guy. Doesn't say if he's got anger issues. He's just there from what we're looking at here.
Yep.
And as you can tell, he's maxed out on two of the four stats he's got. A lot of armor, a lot of power on his special, so makes him quite the extraordinary vehicle to use in this run-through.
You don't recall if his special takes an entire minute to regenerate in this one. We'll find out shortly, though. This guy also has no story, but if you're able to decode what it says right there, you'd find out what it is. According to GameFAQs, though, it says, "I do not think this is real." I have to go back and decode that myself just to make sure.
Satellite of you at the very beginning.
Yep.
That looks like Axel paying for it. Well, he's the one that did it to you. Get yourself a Karagi's Beast. And actually, it was just enough to finish the job on Axel. Not take a thing. Although that does for some reason. It already got you down to a quarter of your health.
Yep.
Usually if you pound on him for a good amount of time, he leaves you alone. That's what I've noticed with roadkill.
Well, it doesn't look like his special takes a minute to regenerate. Probably have to look at the Rahi's stat sheet to find out.
Yeah.
I don't remember. It might be less, might be more. So that didn't seem like a minute, though.
Well, a minute does pass quick when you're having fun.
Yeah, I don't think this guy moves like this online. Seems to be a bit quicker.
Yeah, I think online he kind of slowed him down a good amount. Kind of neutered his special a little bit. eat some of it.
Yeah, nice choice. Too bad.
No base McCutcheon wants any of you. Pretty much playing it safe the whole game so far, what I've looked at. To get percentage of a percentile. Nice about how to take it. So you got it. Kill still alive.
That game went slow there.
Yeah, it tends to do that. A lot of pixelation going on.
It's the first time I've seen it go slow, actually. Usually, I've only seen that happen when you play it on the PlayStation 2 or 3. Never here, though.
And you got 2-for-1 in that way. You got roadkill on that as well.
It's probably for the best.
Well, yeah, the guy does an incredible amount of damage when he's in AI. I want to say his special probably almost rivals that of Warhawk can do to you. I mean, is that powerful?
Which weapon though? The giant Plinko?
Yeah, I'm thinking the Plinkos. I mean, even then, I think the Plinko still does a little less damage than a weapon from a roadkill.
Running away quite a bit.
Yeah, he knows what you got. I don't think he wants any of it. Flaming shower, if you will. And it looks like, I think Yellow Jacket may be the last one.
Yep, he is.
Question is he going to stock up on weapons, or... So answer that question. Burn him to death. Hit a pedestrian that's running around there.
Yep, some random person.
Yeah, so you guys are being in the junkyard after hours. They're gonna go suburbs. And in this case, he says,
I must speak in code or he will discover me.
About that freeze, like I said in another video, that using a weapon on him while you're doing it, it just got the damage. Almost acts like an armor for him. You got the intended target with it, though.
Weapon I meant to use.
She's got some thick armor, didn't quite go to waste on the way. She didn't want any what you were selling. And you just saw your shield. Crazy guy. got a winning shot on you when a shooter distracted you.
I think he hit me with the gas can. Not really too sure. Kind of hoping to go without dying at all. Guess even on hard, do you have a death or two?
Yeah, it's definitely not unusual to have that.
Of course, that's if you're playing it safe and everything, yeah, I suppose it's possible.
If you play it safe, you can probably go with death without dying. Just avoiding any harm, any people that do lots of damage to you, whatever it takes. Hiding, sniping, those are things to do if you want to play it safe. To the downtown district.
We are trapped in his head.
Yeah, this looks right, actually. Counting the numbers for the actual coding on it. See a crazy engine as a go. Very soon. That people take it for you. ice cream shipments there for the next month. Definitely not the usual people you have last.
This is how he sees the world. How Sweet Tooth sees his life. It is not real.
Sweet Tooth here gives up a name.
Yep.
So not to be confused with the driver of Spectre or Bloody Mary or the driver of Crazy Eight, Hank, you know, Fracknell Face McCutcheon. It's actually Sweet Tooth. Take him out.
Yep. All of us are trapped in his head.
So, well, it's kind of strange. No refuge for Dollface, Mr. Grimm, or any of those guys that are out there, then apparently. They're all in Mr. Sweetie's mind.
He is the worst car in the game.
Statistically, not so much, but yeah, if you put him on mine, he's the big guy to go after for your points.
Well, I think he drives a little bit better in this one, to tell you the truth.
Yeah, as I said before, though, I'm pretty sure that offline he's really good, but online, not so much. Warthog beats the crap out of him as far as the vehicle goes. Nice paint shot. He's just so funny. He's like, yeah, I needed to take a shower. It's that pig stink.
Was all roadkill there.
He's going to be seeking revenge against the guy.
I may.
And if he's the one that orchestrated the attack, I wouldn't blame you.
He's a powerful vehicle, there's no doubt about that, if you have infinite weapons and your special charges at max all the time.
Yeah, I said he pretty much gives Warhawk a run for his money in this game, with how powerful it is. And you played as him in one of the playthroughs, I know that. Not sure if he was any better or if he was any worse in your playthrough, though.
For roadkill?
Yeah.
He's a decent vehicle. Just seems a whole lot better when the computer uses them.
try to get you. Just counted as actual being last. It was like the same time, pretty much.
So which level?
Who would drive in?
I believe I missed the old colorful world is next. So I think I said all of us are trapped in his head.
Yep.
That went after the helicopter, at least it hit something.
Yeah, it's still a waste though. A little bit of a little bonus that time. I think it's anytime you do the freeze though, it's kind of pleasant.
Thank you.
really thought he missed you.
And he's not supposed to die yet, right?
No, because Axel technically got it on account of that, even though the other vehicle got it. It's only gonna happen again, from the looks of it.
Yeah, you know, the special does go everywhere, so.
Jeez, that's two in a row. That's terrible. I may have to do the playthrough the next time with this guy.
There will be no other playthrough. Yeah, that's beyond my control there when the computer kills a person for you.
Yeah, I suppose you're right. He did do that shockwave. And amazingly enough, he usually does that rule where he doesn't hurt him at all, but yet this time it did break the rule.
We will return to our world one day.
He'll return to his world one day.
Yeah, he said, we will return to our world one day.
So
this isn't, it's like a dream world, I guess.
So Agent Stone, the Preacher, Raven, they're all actual people got through the Sugar Man.
Probably.
Dargrim Shadow, and I'm not sure who the fourth one is. A little crazy, he's got a couple.
See if he wants to go.
Well, he'll have that choice. Well, it's got two lives left.
Yeah, I gotta come back with more weapons anyway.
Yeah, I only have two measly old fire missiles anyway.
It's one of the disadvantages to holding down the tight turn almost all of the time.
Couldn't have been as bad as when I was knocked off the rooftop by a yellow jacket on my last life when I was using Shadow. That was just terrible.
Yeah, I remember that.
Definitely one of the Wall of Shame's greatest plays there, I guess you could say. Every know it's not hard when you play like a pro and they freeze you right in the middle of your doing your special.
Hey, you only see that kind of stuff online.
I think that's gonna knock her right off.
Yep.
Yep. You rammed right into her and that. No, I think Mr. Grimm's last. He's way out there.
So that means Junker fell off too then?
No, you killed him. Yeah.
It just happened so quickly.
Yeah, almost like you killed one after the other, basically, what happened. Yeah, he's got like a pretty much an Ice Cube's chance in hell, but let's see how he does here. Well, yeah, he was...
Thought he had full health.
No, he pretty much... Ah!
Just barely missed it.
I'm gonna rip off.
In the real world, my name is Marcus Kane.
So all you Twisted Metalers out there that play the game series, you know that's the driver of Roadkill in Twisted Metal 2. Should have hit.
Surprised it didn't count.
He was like right in front of that
I'm killed them with nothing but flame balls. Of course, this guy gets no ending.
Yep, that he does not.
Yep, for some reason.
Yeah, but one of the theories I know they have is that Marcus Kane and Needles Kane are one and the same person. That's the story they got going, I guess, with this guy.
Yeah, so it's pretty much Sweet Tooth's dreams or his mind that came up with all these stories.
Yeah, well, what's really unusual about it is you incorporate what they have in, say, Twisted Metal head-on. Marcus Kane and Needles Kane both have a different weight and height, but yet they're the same person. I mean, how does that happen?
Couldn't tell you.
Yes, I mean, there's a couple of flaws in the story for that. Like, I mean, it's not like a Clark Kent Superman thing where obviously the same height, same weight, but for some reason they can't figure out that Clark Kent is Superman after he just puts on a pair of glasses, which, you know, make me more feasible. The only other thing you can think of is if you were to, say, ever watch the new He-Man and the Masters of the Universe series, where, let's say you've got, you know, Prince Adam, obviously a smaller guy, smaller kid, and then he turns into this hulking group He-Man when he, you know, chances, you know, enchantment, and then turns into He-Man. So you got that weight thing going on there. So my only conclusion is something like that must have to happen when Marcus Kane, you know, turns into Needles Kane. So, but then again, I'm just throwing stuff out there at this point with that.
Well, I know at TMA they had like all the theories and the lore and all that for the Twisted Metal series, but I don't know if that still exists on TMA in its current form.
Yeah, there's actually a couple ideas I've been tossing around with that. I know another idea I was thinking about was the actual origin and how they came up with the idea of Sweet Tooth. And in the future, I may actually have a video coming out with regards to a presentation on where he came from, what he's all about. Same thing with Yellow Jacket, because he's actually a character from a movie from in the 80s, and obvious similarities of that particular character. So that may happen in the future. We're going to work on that. May not be today. It's not, definitely not going to be tomorrow.
So I think you forgot to mention that the driver of Crazy 8 looks like Bruce Willis.
Yeah, Bruce Willis would make a perfectly good actor for Crazy 8. I mean, I don't see where they got John Leguizamo from. I mean, he looks exactly like the guy. And I always used to think that the perfect guy for Sweet Tooth would have been the guy that was in Predator 2, not Danny Glover, but the other guy, Gary Busey, because of the teeth. I mean, he just looks kind of crazy looking in his own way there, but he's a little older now, so. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching us play these games. We definitely enjoyed making them for you, so if you've definitely liked it, definitely leave a thumbs up for us, and we'll see you around.